this that we've been actually discussing here, the parts that you've heard. What was the last question? Not the one that was actually sent to Gigi, but prior to that, was the last question?
I think that was Kadora's question, wasn't it? No, it was
Treadwife. I got some questions for you. So the last time you were stating that you may have an entrance, or you may have been considering polygamy. Initially, you was against it. What brought you to that particular stage in your development?
Well, when I we live on the land, like right on the land, off grid, and it's a very different lifestyle, you know, than living in the city and stuff like that. And once I got out here and we were doing the farming and all that kind of stuff, I realized why polygamy is necessary, is because you can't get everything done that needs to be done, or you're just scrambling all the time to take care of everything that needs to be taken care of. And it's actually the only thing that makes sense, you know, is to have that other wife there. And also because of, you know, reading the Bible and stuff like that. And it actually just came up between me and my husband one night, and I said to him, you know, I would just love if there was another woman around to help me with the children and with all the things I have to do here while you're gone, right? We have animals and stuff like that too. And like, we just started talking about it every day, kind of. And that's how I came to think it was the best thing for our family anyways. And then that's when I started dealing with, oh, what about the jealousy and all that? And that's when I started doing the visualization and things like that. And now to me, it's just like something that I really want. I see all the problems, lots of problems that we have, like in our household and stuff, could be fixed by having that extra set of hands there. You know what I mean? And also the relationship between two women, there's a certain, not sexual, but there is like an affection and an emotional relationship that two women can have as sisters that a woman can't really have with her husband. You know what I mean? It's not good for a man to be in those emotions and stuff all the time. Whereas if you have a sister wife, you have someone there to help you deal with those things. So that was the other part of that. And I did have one question for you, for the men too, as I was just wondering if, what you guys thought about the wife, the first wife, finding the second wife, as opposed to the husband finding the second wife, and if there were any problems with doing things that way.
Thank you.
You guys want to respond to that? What do you guys think about your first wife finding a wife for you?
Well, Jason said thank you. There's examples of that in the scriptures, and that's definitely okay. I see it. There's been directive, and basically, you know, when a woman does that, not only are you saying you're okay with it, but you're being a blessing, you know, to your husband in that fashion. You're relieving, you know, everybody wins in that moment. So if you're bringing them, there should be, like you said, a certain level of closeness and trust between the sister. That should be like an underlying factor. So if it happens, you know, to me, I don't see a woman bringing another woman in a situation, someone who she doesn't hold in some, you know, regard. So that should alleviate a lot of them emotional type of issues and jealousy. And also, y'all should probably already have some kind of rapport. So I would say that's, you know, that would make things, you know, a lot easier, and will give you your husband's favor as well.
What do you think about that, Benaya? Agree to that?
I would agree to that. I mean, just even getting to that point of the first wife even bringing another sister into the fold, that's a different type of woman.
What do you think about that, Eric?
I think that would be good too. That seems like that would cut down a whole lot of.
Okay, Kadar, what do you think about that? So we got
that decision is ultimately the husband's decision, because he's the one that's in charge and gonna really have to be the one to, you know, direct and lead that family.
I don't see nothing wrong with it. You know what I'm saying? I feel like the first wife already know, you know what I'm saying, the operations of the home and what's going on. And, you know, I know exactly, you know, what to look for and, you know, to bring in someone that's suitable now to be able to function properly within, you know, the operation and help things flourish. So, you know, I don't see nothing wrong with that.
Okay. So I'm going to have to interject here. So one of the reasons that I disagree with that is that, first of all, the first wife might have the same type of mindset that Gigi has. And none of you guys are looking at that, right? Apparently, she want to bring her in for a reason. She already built the bond with her. She has some sort of relationship, right? So the only time I think something like that is feasible, if it's the first wife has a best friend, and you guys heard me say this on the call, and her best friend is single, right? Because she already know the best friend. But otherwise, you're allowing the woman to choose a
It's cutting
up.
I think you're cutting out.
She didn't look masculine. I'm not talking about her appearance, but her demeanor. She was overly masculine. And so the man's supposed to be able to have the ability and some insight and say, I think this might be bad. For, you know, it'll do more harm than good. Because now this woman's going to bring in a challenge because of her masculinity is going to be challenging the man. You understand what I'm saying? Some women have a tendency to be attracted to women because that woman is masculine. And the other woman is putting herself in a subservient position. So men, you know, when you do these things, you really got to do them with wisdom. I'm not saying that the woman could be wrong by that because remember, When Sarah told Abraham, go into my handmaid, Hagar, and give me a child, Abraham didn't want to do it in the beginning. And then the Most High say, hearken to the voice of your wife. You understand what I'm saying? But ultimately, how did that turn out? When Hagar had the baby, she started taunting Sarah. And then Sarah said, kick this woman out with a child. And he didn't want to do it. And then the Most High say, hearken to the voice of thy wife. Kicked them out, and they was kicked out in the wilderness. So she running around, and from her is where the people that refer to themselves as Arabs came today. That's what the word Arab mean, a nomad, a person that roams from place to place. You understand what I'm saying? So you got to be very, very cautious in those kind of, you know, interventions where you're allowing, your woman to, you know, make those kind of decisions. You better have good trust. Now, if you know your woman, and if you sit down to her, this is the kind of woman that I want. You see what I'm saying? If she's bringing someone in that's totally in opposition, because chances are you may want another woman like her. You understand what I'm saying? Or you may not, because her personality may be like, I want the opposite of you. Find someone that's the opposite of you. But is she really going to look out for your best interest? All of that stuff has to come into play. You can't say, oh, yeah, that's a blessing. Since she's going to make this decision, hell to the no.
I totally agree on that too. And my husband would always have the final say. And we go over this all the time on like, what is this checklist and this woman that we're looking, that he's looking for, right? But really for me, for a sister wife, and there's a lot of qualifications that would have to happen, you know, and vetting and stuff like that before any decisions were made, you know, during the courting process.
Right.
So yeah, it would never be like my full decision, but if I say like thought I met a woman or whatever who would suit that role, then maybe he would be open, you know what I mean, to look checking that out. Because where we are in the world, it's very hard to find that woman. I'm sure everywhere it is, but particularly hard where we are.
Come on.